Hey everybody, welcome to a brand new episode of Song Theory. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel, guys. We're doing some more content. Now, the backdrop looks a little different because I am currently in the transition of changing my studio setting and my living space and everything, so just bear with me. Hopefully it's not too dark. I'll make sure to change the video in post. Anyway, today we're talking about Tekashi69, and I'm trying to figure out how this kid just keeps popping his head above the water just right before he gets submerged. It is absolutely incredible. Tekashi69 has just signed a $10 million deal with another hip-hop label, and I'm not confused. I understand what's going on, because that particular hip-hop label wants to get clout from everything that's going on with Tekashi69, and everyone knows that Tekashi either has music in a vault somewhere ready to be released, or he is going to end up making music later on down the road. And what this particular record label wants is they want the opportunity to take that attention and to use it. And so $10 million is nothing compared to the amount of money that this record label and Tekashi are going to get in the coming months, because I guarantee you, if Tekashi dropped a song right now, I'm pretty sure it would hit number one. Because of all the attention he's getting. And I've made videos about Tekashi before, and what I'm trying to figure out is, you know, is this really the treatment that this generation of artists are going to be raised by? Is if you are disrespectful, if you're a snitch, if you are an outcast in society, you're going to get more clout because of it? Because to me at this point, what it seems like is people are giving Tekashi too many chances. I mean, this guy is a snitch if I've ever seen one. Now, forget the fact that he wasn't a part of the whole gang affiliation. He wasn't part of the whole, he wasn't a real gang member. That doesn't matter. He was a part of it. He did it. He did the deeds. He did the work as well as anybody else who he paid. And to me, I think that it's wrong to sit here and give him another platform to work off of. And I think it's ridiculous, because what you're trying to tell people and kids is that you can put yourself in these situations and you can get out of it just as easily as you got in it. And I think that's ridiculous and wrong. I think it's ridiculous to sit here and just believe that Tekashi69 can just get a free $10 million pass just like that. And not to mention, this particular record label could have gotten any up-and-coming hip-hop star from any of the 50 states. But no, they chose to go for Tekashi69. And I think it's sad because they're working off of another logic too. If Tekashi69 ends up getting killed shortly after doing a song or a few performances, that record label still makes money off of his name. That record label still makes money off of his death. The whole time. It doesn't matter what happens to Tekashi, because once he signed on the dotted line, that $10 million is not going to mean anything if he's cold, dead, and in the grave. So I think that this is a great business deal for the AR team. I think it's a great deal for the management. I think it's a great deal for the actual the record label, because they're going to make their money regardless. And it's sad because they're exploiting Tekashi. They're not giving him wise counsel, wise advice. The wise thing to do would be to keep your head low and just wait it out. But no, they're playing off of his emotions. They're playing off of who Tekashi is. And essentially, he just signed on the dotted line. And unfortunately, I'm not sure if, I don't know if he's going to live long enough to enjoy the fruits of that. And I think that's the craziest part, is that, you know, we often forget that when you snitch on people, or when you tell, or when you testify, however you want to call it, you're putting yourself in a position where you are going to put your family and yourself in bodily harm and danger. And so to be so blatant, to be so bold, to sign a $10 million record deal after doing something like that is just one of the craziest things I've seen some crazy stuff in my day. Okay, I've seen some insane hip-hop artists do some insane things. But Tekashi's story is probably the craziest I've heard so far. Not only do you get yourself mixed up in one of the most powerful gangs in New York, once you get mixed up with them, you end up getting caught, okay, after tireless work from the FBI. And you get caught and you're on trial, and then you proceed to snitch on every person you've ever worked with, including people you've never worked with, like Jim Jones and Cardi B. And so it's to the extent that I'm concerned at this point, because I'm trying to figure out what the next step is. I'm trying to figure out what's going to happen, because there's one of two things going to happen. Either he's going to get himself killed, or he's going to be as successful as I hope he's not, but he might end up being. And so in the coming months, we'll basically see what happens next. At this particular point, I hope you guys just keep up with the story. I know I'm keeping up with the story. I'm trying my very best to make sure that I am keeping up with every single beat, because I want to see what happens when he gets out. I want to see what he does then, because my theory is that he's going to get out and he's going to act a total, complete, absolute fool. And he might end up getting himself or somebody he knows killed. So let's just keep up with the story. But anyway, guys, I appreciate you watching the channel. Thank you so much for liking, subscribe, sharing. I do have a Patreon under Song Theory. Guys, please go on there. Please donate to the cause. I'm trying to make more videos, trying to make more content for you guys. And I would love if you guys were to donate $1, $2, $5, $10. It doesn't matter. Just please go to my Patreon, go check it out, and go see how you can help the channel today. Thank you guys so much for watching. And once again, make sure you subscribe, like, and share. And there's more content coming to you guys very soon. Thank you so much. Have a great day and a better tomorrow. God bless. I'll see you guys later.